But it's a developed country as far as its intellectual infrastructure is concerned. And therefore, I strongly believe that in the 21st century, India is going to be the global research, design and development center of the world. It is patent, publish and prosper. Create wealth out of our own intellectual property, which should be as strong as anywhere else in the world.
Not the glib words of a seasoned politician, but the concrete conviction of a scientist technologist who has created history in the research circles in India. The Director General of CSIR and Secretary to the Government of India. World acclaimed chemical scientist and the third Indian FRS in the 20th century. Dr. Raghunath Anant Mashelkar, the man with the Midas touch.
I remember my childhood spent in Girgaon.
I still remember those old days. What a struggle it was. I went to a Marathi school, a municipal school, West Khetwadi Upper Primary School, I still remember. It was a big struggle. I still remember for the exams, Saturdays they used to be held and we had to get a paper, the question paper, which cost 3 paise. And on a Saturday we didn't have those 3 paise. I still remember when I went barefoot to the school until I was 12 years old.
After ranking 11th in InterScience in 1960, he bagged the second rank in the university in 1962.
In fact, I wanted to be a mechanical engineer. I did not like chemistry. It will come as a surprise from a former director of National Chemical Laboratory. And it was by accident that I went to UDCT. And I'm so glad I did, because if I did not, then I would not have met my great guru, Professor M.M. Sharma. 1966, I joined him. 1969, I finished my PhD. But my mother has been fantastic. What she would do, although she would not know, because she herself is not educated, when I did my SSC, she said, there must be something further. InterScience, there must be something further. I finished BKM, no, you must go ahead. I finished my PhD and I said, my God, now that's the end of it. She said, no, there must be something further.
And to pursue further research, he left for the University of Salford in England.
But that was also a very interesting turning point in my life, because I was already in love with Vaishali. I wanted to ask for a hand.
At first, I refused.
I mean, I had a Saraswati, but no Lakshmi at that point in time.
Raghunath and Vaishali soon tied the knot in the true marriage of science and art.
We got married on 16th August 1976. Within a fortnight, we left India to go to the UK.
Little did she know then that she was to be known in later years as the wife of one of the most illustrious scientists in the world.
When he received news of his first award, he made the first call to our residence. I was the one to pick up the receiver. And when he gave me the news, I was dumbstruck, just didn't know what to say, and I started crying. That's when I realized what an important man my husband is.
As a scientist, administrator and as an individual, Dr. Mashelkar's infectious confidence charged each and every person near him. And when he held his ground before the US Patent Office for India's turmeric patent, this confidence was evident.
The case of turmeric patent is a very historical one. It was a landmark case, because that was for the first time from the third world, there was a protest. The wound healing properties of turmeric are known in India for centuries. And yet one discovered one fine morning that there was a American patent that was granted on that. We decided to take up that particular case, and within 14 months, I'm very proud to say that patent was revoked. Although it was a small step, it did a number of things. Number one, it gave confidence to India that we can win. We also saw what the game of patents all about. We got confidence that, we are not helpless spectators, that anyone can come and appropriate our knowledge to themselves.
A confidence born out of a mother's dream.
It was my humble wish that about 40 to 50 people should work under his guidance.
these expectations were more than met when he took over the reins as Director General of the Mammoth CSIR in 1995, with its 40 labs and a staff of more than 25,000.
Let's be a team CSIR. Also, let us do research as business and also in a business-like manner, that it changed both the product as well as the process by which we do basically the research. So we started bringing in several reforms. All of us met and decided that we must have a new vision. We set up what is called a CSIR 2001 vision and strategy.
And he earned it the exalted title of CSIR Incorporated.
Now that he has reached these heights, I do not know what else he can do. But if there is any further degree he can pursue, he should.
Was achieving the supreme honor of being the third Indian Fellow of the Royal Society in the 20th century the answer to this grand old lady's expectations?
If you focus, you can achieve anything in the world.
Whether it is being a great scientist, a global celebrity, a responsible father, or a humble devotee of Ganpati. With so many interesting shades to his personality, there may be still so many more we haven't seen.
I like Goan food. It's the best. I love fish. I do not like formal clothes. I like simple clothes, but they must be clean. I love old Hindi films. I like a light and happy atmosphere.
I want everybody to be happy in the company.
I like to think positive. One must think big.
But one thing is for sure. This phenomenon called Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar is a man with the Midas touch.